So, Pap, obviously a couple of things in the news this week, but one of the stories that has not been covered at all, of course, is another story of massive corporate, I don't know if I would call this fraud or certainly law-breaking, and it's really just a question of they're going to be held to account. Of course, I'm talking about this GlaxoSmithKline story.
Yeah, well, no, the reason the media hasn't talked about it is because the corporate media knows that Glaxo is getting ready to spend about $1 billion in advertising this next year. And so, but this is a story where you had Glaxo go to China and spend $500 million in bribery. And what they did is they bribed doctors, they bribed hospitals, they bribed government officials all the way up to the top regulatory agency. And some of the ways they bribed them is with prostitution, with trips out of the country, with cars, with houses, and just with old cold hard cash. So, I mean, it went through about, traveled through about 700-800 third parties. And in the end, what ended up happening is GlaxoSmithKline, everybody's wondering, how is it that their sales in Asia are doubling everybody else's sales? Well, because they're bribing everybody. And, you know, this is the same company, Sam, that they had to pay $3 billion just last year for criminal fraud, and where they were lying to doctors, lying to regulators, lying to customers about the safety of their drugs. And so, the story just goes on, because in the media, you try to find this in corporate media, this story. You can't. Happened in China. It's a UK company that does business all over America. And I mean, the people running it at the top, they knew about it. They act like they didn't. They said, oh, this is shameful conduct, and we got to get this under control. And it's been going on for about 5 years, and they act like they just figured out why their sales are doubling everybody else in China.
Now, Pap, let me ask you this. Now, a company that is based in Britain, if this company was based in United States, it would be clear to me that it would be subject to the Foreign Corrupt Practices Act. This is the one where if a company is engaging in bribery of officials in a foreign country, that they're breaking the law in the United States. Is that the same here with
Glaxo? Yeah, they could do something here. If we had somebody wanting to go after them, they could. But I don't expect that to happen, Sam. But, I mean, this is going on in the United States just in different ways. I mean, you've got in the United States, what they do is they bribe by way of going to universities and having doctors create these false reports about the safety of clinical data on a drug. They'll go to they'll create some speaker out of the clear blue who really doesn't know anything about the drug, but they school them up on the drug and then pay them $400,000 to go give speeches about how safe it is, when the person making the speech really doesn't know anything about it other than what he's been told. Yeah, they just got so many scams working in the United States. It's just they just disguise it different. But here, right now we don't have any cases of them actually going out and buying prostitutes like they did all over Asia. But they bought prostitutes for people at the very top. I mean, you've had people already arrested over in China at the top, and you can bet nobody would have been arrested in the United States. But this story is just another story of sex, drugs, and bribery, and big drugs gone wild. That's what this story's about.